has helped these immigration communities over the last decades. I don't want to see all this this work to be seen to as gone to waste. So the council's done a great job in bringing immigration communities together. It's done a lot to tackle discrimination in the city. Also, a lot more work needs to be done, as the lady said before, from the Scottish community who came in the year on last year. I would like the council to fully support her and to help new immigration communities. And also, it's right that the council should write to the President of the EU.
Made our ward their home and one of the few
So as the lead for community safety, I have been extremely concerned by the rising hate crimes that we've seen across the UK as a result of the EU referendum. Unacceptable acts and intolerance are increasing on the streets of our country. It is clear that for some people, the referendum was about much more than our membership of the EU, and that for a minority, it has legitimised their racism and xenophobia. But racism is never acceptable. As Councillor Key outlined earlier, I am somewhat heartened that Liverpool has not seen the same rise. We haven't seen the same increase in hate crimes, and we're not seeing the same public displays of disgusting intolerance on our streets. And I think this is, in part, a great testament to the strength of our community and those organisations who support them. They will not allow the fear and the hatred to break up our city. We are a proud and welcoming, vibrant and progressive city. And Kushner also spoke earlier from Colonia and highlighted some of the challenges that we do still face. There are still many groups, as Councillor Beaumont just highlighted, that do still need to be called out for their actions. And we need to ensure that our commitment to our communities doesn't falter at this very difficult time. And we must also join with our fellow cities, towns, villages across Merseyside, across the North West and across the whole of the UK to make it clear that this behaviour is wrong. It will never be acceptable. And the Tories, who let this referendum happen, and sorry, Councillor, but it's very irresponsible, who have sanctioned a cruel rise in poverty and desperation across the country, and who have implicitly encouraged division to take hold in our communities, it must be held accountable. I'm very proud of Liverpool, who did vote for Remain, and we will continue to work with our partners to remain a vibrant, multicultural and European city. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Sproul. Councillor Nicholas and Councillor Nicholas is the last speaker before we go back to Councillor Mander.
Thank you. Thanks for the opportunity to speak. I know a lot of councillors have shared, and I just felt that it was imperative of me to share
stand in your name, please?
Hello there, Councillor Parsons is going to do the motion.
Sorry?
Councillor Liz Parsons is going to do the motion, I'll second it.
Can I also remind Councillor that this is Councillor Liz Parsons' maiden speech, and to offer due respect to her, then, please.
Thank you. Have we got any other speakers, Councillor Kushner?
just very briefly, and I just to add a little bit to underline what was said in Councillor Parsons' excellent made speech. That was really well put, and he says absolutely quite rightly what this bill is at the committee stage, and what one of the proposals in the bill is to suspend the Children Act, which can only mean that is only there to encourage local authority to outsource children's services to children's trusts. We've heard this all before, and my right honourable Nick Small will be talking about it. But this is childcare academisation, and this council, we will not support the academisation of children's services in this city. Regulation of social workers will do nothing to encourage the kind of reflective and professional practice that Councillor Parsons is talking about, and she exhibits her own practice that she's seen herself. But just very briefly, the bill offers us two further opportunities. One is to clear up an anomaly regarding family courts. Family court judges are allowed to make judgments and with their decisions about children's social care that are above a regulatory regime and above inspection and accountability, sufficient accountability. The case of Eddie Butler, when the recommendation of social work was overruled to take that child away from the loving grandparents and placed with an auntie, and subsequently that child then died, is something that should send warning signals to us, because in this city, the family judge in this city has overruled our overall social worker recommendations in around 160 cases to place children who are under child protection back with parents under a care order. That's against the recommendation of our own social workers. Just to give you an example of what that means, in Sheffield, which has more children than we have, they have only 16 of those cases. So I think that my proposal and in this motion is to make the judges accountable for those decisions, and for there to be open to inspection within the remit of social care. The final thing I want to say, the UN report on children's rights a couple of weeks ago recommended quite rightly that no decision by government should be taken without a true assessment of what the impact will be on children. The UN report 2 weeks ago, 2 or 3 weeks ago, made a recommendation that there should be a cabinet position just to represent children, and that any decisions made by government and by cabinet government should assess the impact that decision has on children and families. And I think that should be incorporated into the Children's Social Work Bill, and indeed that should be extended to local authorities, because I think that every decision that we make should also be measured against what impact it will have on children and families in our city. Whether that's to do with how much they're paid, what type of jobs they've got, what housing they're in, what health they're entitled to, what youth provision they get. In all those areas, we should make sure that also happens in this city, so that we can reach together an ambition to make Liverpool a child-friendly city.
Failure. You only need to look in the league tables in relation to academies.
more worrying, I think, because if you look at the new changes to Ofsted, particularly in social care inspections, and when you look at the inspection outcomes in Tory authorities to Labour authorities, that is also a worry about how biased some of those inspections may or may not be, and whether part of that is about privatisation by the back door when they are actually bringing improvement boards in and improvement officers into local authorities. Social care is a very hard occupation to work in, whether you work as a support worker, a social worker, or in any other aspect. They're demonised by the press, demonised by the public, and for those families who really rely on that support, it's another kick in the teeth to think that there could be such a fragmentation. So I fully support the motion, and I urge everybody in this council to take on board their corporate parenting role, and actually to visit our children within their children's home, take up big,
are there any other speakers? No? Okay then, I'm going to move to the vote. Who's responding to this? Who's winding up? Is it you or?
Thoughtful response to citizens with council tax arrears. We are using what money we have left after the government's savage cuts to top up our discretionary housing scheme, to fund a very flexible and responsive local welfare scheme, our own Liverpool support scheme, as well as fund our benefit maximisation service, which is now working even more closely with the Liverpool Health Network in the city. This motion quite rightly places on record the Council's thanks to our city's voluntary organisations, our faith-based organisations, our charities, our donors, our schools, our businesses, our community groups, our volunteers, our council officers and our mayor, who have been working with and responding to the needs of all our citizens of all ages who are impacted so badly by the government's welfare reforms. But we are also working upstream with our partners to prevent poverty and inequality, carrying out recommendations from the Mayor's Fairness Commission, supporting, growing and promoting our local businesses that are purpose, not just profit driven, and who pay a real living wage, not just one penny less a month. And we carry on making Liverpool a strong city built on fairness. But we will also continue to hold this government to account. And that is the purpose behind requesting that our Chief Executive write to, one, the new Secretary of State for Work and Pensions, two, the relevant United Nations departments, and as well, the Chief Executive of the Public Health England, who has a specific duty to, in quotes, speak truth to power. Our little man Jack, who I said to him, what do you want to be called? But he was suffering really severe food poverty because I wanted to get his story out there. And he said, I'll be called Jack by Jack Sparrow. So, okay, we'll call him Jack. So little man Jack, who is still, along with school friends, often hungry, says it like this, as Liverpool children often do, and he told me to get this message to the government. He wrote, listen to me, you're grown-ups. He's age 7. Listen to me, you're grown-ups. This is bad. You are being bad unless you do something with K about it. So Jack, we're listening. The question is, will government, well, watch this space?
My Lord Mayor, as the councillor for Central Ward, on my many visits to residents, I see firsthand the suffering and injustice brought on by this government's welfare reforms.